was that? I'm talking to Steve, who is a
room guide
at Erddig House in Wales, and he's going to just tell me a bit about some of the artwork and information that's here.
Well, this object behind me here, this notice on the wall, is called a hatchment.
Right.
And this was something that was hung outside the main gates of the house when somebody inside died, to let passers-by know that there'd been a bereavement in the house. Well, this is for one of the butlers, George Dickinson, who died, as you can see on it, in 1888. And it was rather unfortunate that he needed a minor operation. And in the days before local hospitals, the surgeon came to the house in order to perform the operation. And legend has it that it was on this table in the servants' hall. Well, previously, one of the things he'd done for the family in Erddig, the children of the Yorks, was to kill and preserve insects for them by killing them with chloroform and sticking them to pins on a cart. It turns out, in the end, the operation on him was successful, but he died from the effects of the chloroform. So he was killed from the very same chloroform that he'd used to kill and preserve the insects. So no doubt the insects saw that as natural justice.
Exactly. And you were also telling me about this gentleman here.
Well, this is Thomas Rogers. He was a carpenter in Erddig for a period of about 60 years. And the story goes that in 1815 he was captured by the press gang working out of Liverpool to be pressed into the Royal Navy and taken off to fight in the Napoleonic Wars. Normally they only took experienced seamen, but because he was a carpenter, they obviously thought his skills would be useful in a navy of wooden ships. Well, before he was finally hauled off to life on the ocean wave, he requested that he have one last meeting with his master. And he was brought here to Simon Yorke, who simply paid off the press gang. So he was bought out of his press life in the Navy and returned to life in Erddig, where he worked very gratefully for about the next 30 or 40 years.
And of course, there are all these other servants in the portraits in the servants' hall. And this lady, you told me here. Now,
her
the light's
Jane
a little
Everill.
Bit bad there. I'm going to move a little bit so we
her
can see her
Jane
a little
Everill,
better, maybe.
And she was she'd been a servant in Erddig for about 60 years. She was 87 when this painting was painted in 1793, and completely unique to Erddig, Philip Yorke I had these paintings painted of the servants and actually wrote some poetry about them. Underneath, describing her, he described in the poem, he used the phrase, mother to us all, because of her great age. She'd married one of the coachmen, and in turn they had a son who also became a coachman. In her old age, she didn't want to accept a pension, so he gave her this nominal job called spider brusher to the master. And so she simply went around and flicked a few cobwebs and therefore was carried on till she eventually died here. But this portrayal of servants with poetry is unique to Erddig. It was far more common for 18th century landowners to paint pictures of their prized cattle than it was their servants. But this is one of the delightful aspects of social history that we find in Erddig.
It's just fascinating. Steve, thank you so much. I appreciate that. And I think you've got a fascinating room to work in. For sure.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay.